Hello, my wonderful people. Welcome to Fola Top Concepts. If you are new to this channel, this is Fola Top Concepts. Yes, Fola Top Concepts. Today's recipe is all about my delicious wedge potato that I made. Yes, this wedge potato is with a twist because even somebody that doesn't even like potato wedge, who doesn't like eating potato at all, we fell in love with this recipe. This is my already cleaned potato and already peeled. So what I'm just doing is cutting it into wedges and putting it inside water. So that is what I'm just doing. And after cutting this potato, I'm going to put it on fire. I'm going to put it on fire and allow it to boil just once. Once it is boiled, I will remove it from fire and stop the cooking process before I fry. Yes, that is my already washed and the clean potato ready to be put on fire. So I'm going to cover it and allow it to cook. After one boil, that's all. These are my ingredients that I'm going to be using for my potato wedge. This is my Maggi. And after my Maggi, I have my thyme, I have my ginger, I have my cannel, I have poivron, which is black pepper, I have my curry, my pepper, my lye, what do you call it in English? I've forgotten. No, in Yoruba is haju, grounded haju. I've forgotten the name has gone as it appeared, and my salt. Those are the things that I have. This mixture, yes, this is the only thing I'm using. And we have just onions and tomatoes, just one tomatoes. Yes, I'm not using the regular things, no egg, no other things. Then I'm adding flour instead of using all those other things like egg. I'm not using that thing, those things. I'm using onions, one tomato. And my ingredients, my spices, that's all. And I'm going to add flour. Yes, flour that will not be too thick. If it comes out too thick, you can add water, because that was what exactly happened to me in this video. The flour I added was too much, so I had to add more water to what I did. Yes. And please, if you are new to this channel, welcome to Fola Top Concepts. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment, and share with your families and friends. That way you support me. Please support your girl, support your sister, support your daughter. Please, 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 I'm just begging you to please support me and help my channel grow. So I'm mixing it now. That is it. The potato is already boiled. It's boiling. The water is boiling. So I don't want it to overcook. Just to cook it a little bit. Can you see the thickness of this thing? So I had to add water. It's too thick. So I had to add water. That's the water beside me that I'm going to add. But I want to first mix it very well before adding another water. So what I will do to the potato is that I'm going to remove the hot water and pass through cold water so that I'll stop the cooking process and become cool before I start frying it. So I added a little bit of water. So that's what I'm doing. I'm passing it, I'm pouring it into the sieve. Then remove the hot water, add cold water so that it can cool down. That's all that I'm doing before I now start the frying process. Yes, this potato here. I have somebody in my house that doesn't like potato at all. I tried this recipe out. So just my DIY, I created it myself. Person was like, wow, how did you make this thing? I was like, did you like it? He said, yes, it came out very good. I said, okay, It's my recipe. I was the one that created it myself. So since then, sometimes I fry it like this. Not always, because you know now, frying is not really healthy. So I added my onions, yes, to add to the flavor of what I want to fry. So that's what I just did. And that's my potato that has been drained. Add the potato into the flour mix. Then put it on fire and fry. Please, please and please, just try out this recipe. Yes, just try it out. You would really, 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 really love this recipe. I promise you, yes. I didn't use anything that much. You know, onions is very good now. So I use onions and just one tomatoes. Then you fry on medium to high heat. Yes. Not too low and not too high. So that we can achieve a perfectly cooked potato wedge. Yes. And our potato wedge is ready. You know how I hate my own. Don't worry now. You see the way I'm going to serve my own. You know somebody that is trying to somebody that is trying to watch with that still cannot cope what your she's doing. I'm reducing what I'm eating actually. But anytime I'm trying to eat something that is not healthy, that is the way I eat it. I always have a way of eating my unhealthy foods. So our potato wedge is ready. Look at how it came out. Don't worry, it's running away. Even if it run away, I'm going to pick it. So it's ready. I'm putting it inside my plate. So that's it. Now it's just for us to serve our potato. I cannot wait to eat this because this is my second time of trying this recipe out. Yes, because my family members, they fell in love with this, so I'm trying it. Anytime I do it like this, they always, even the small ones now, we always rush it. So that is it. Look at the brownies, the golden brownies of this thing, and it came out crunchy. Very crunchy. I really, really do love it. I ate my own. I serve it with, I garnish it with onions, pepper, and that drink. You can guess what's inside. You will see now. You already see what is inside now. I have my lime and my homemade apple cider vinegar. Yes. The recipe is coming soon. I make my own homemade apple cider vinegar. Ever since I just bought my apple cider vinegar just once. I only bought once. And that my own is too. Is one of my recipes. I already have a recipe on my channel, which the it will